Hi, I'm Harrison Keeley. Here's a quick look at today's top stories. First of all, the Chattanooga Lookouts baseball team is getting a new major league partner. It said the Lookouts and the Minnesota Twins could announce a partnership as early as this afternoon. The Lookouts had been an affiliate of the Los Angeles Dodgers since 2008, but this year the Dodgers wanted to hook up with Tulsa instead, so they didn't renew their player development contract. Lookouts owner Frank Burke says he appreciates all the Dodgers did for Chattanooga, but he's looking forward to starting a partnership with a new major league team. EPB has admitted overbilling Chattanooga taxpayers more than $1.2 million. It happened while the utility was working to replace older, higher wattage streetlights with more efficient models. EPB President Harold DePriest says the process was so error-ridden that officials couldn't determine how many older streetlights were being replaced. And EPB originally claimed that any overcharges were balanced out by underbilling elsewhere. City Auditor Stan Sewell says the errors are a cause for concern, but he didn't find any intentional wrongdoing. Whether EPB needs to repay the city is still undecided. The Chattanooga Police Department is now offering Spanish classes to officers. The Chattanooga School of Language is teaching the course as part of the police department's Hispanic initiative. The courses are tailored to focus on police situations like traffic stops or arrests. Right now, the department has 8 officers certified in Spanish, but officials say that still doesn't meet demand. A man driving was wounded during a shooting in East Chattanooga Tuesday. Police say Terrence Jordan suffered a non-life-threatening injury while he was driving on Wilson Street. Anyone with information is asked to call the police. 5 people have been arrested after a home burglary in St. Elmo. It happened around noon Tuesday on Sunnyside Drive. Officers arrested one juvenile, 25-year-old Carl Lewis, and 3 teenagers, Kelvin Dozier, Kiaomi Owens, and D'Angelo Foster. All of the stolen items were recovered. Dalton, Georgia has been without a mayor since March. That's when David Pennington stepped down to challenge Governor Nathan Deal in the Republican primary. Now 2 Republican candidates have qualified to run for Dalton mayor. Miller T. Jones III will face off against Dennis Mock in the November election. The winner will serve until January 2016. Mock works for a family-owned company, Whitco Produce. Jones served in the U.S. Navy and works in financial management. A public debate will be held at Dalton City Hall at 7:30 p.m. September 30th. Turning to weather, today will be sunny with a high near 80 degrees. The low tonight will be around 58. That's it for today's newscast. Thanks for being with us. You can find more on these stories and breaking news all day long at timesfreepress.com.